Good morning, 47. The board has sanctioned Eric Soder's for termination. After Colorado, we did some digging into Soder's private affairs and discovered that he has been fast-tracked for critical heart surgery at the hyper-exclusive Gama Private Hospital in Hokkaido, Japan. Such a display of power has Providence written all over it. Soder's, who suffers from a rare condition known as situs inversus, where his internal organs are reversed, desperately needs a right-sided heart transplant and has clearly betrayed the ICA to get it. He was admitted last night and is currently being prepped for a 3-day surgery. We have booked you into Gama under the usual guise of Tobias Reaper, corporate shark, here for a standard medical checkup. As such, you will need to play it by ear and procure whatever tools you need to complete the mission. You also need to eliminate Yuki Yamazaki, a Tokyo lawyer who works for Providence. Sodas has already given Yamazaki access to our client records and has agreed to provide a full list of active ICA operatives post-operation. This transaction cannot be allowed to happen. Sodas must pay for his treachery, and his insidious employers must be taught a lesson. ICA's sovereignty is at stake. Powerful as Providence may be, we need to draw a line in the sand. I will leave you to prepare. 47 ways
to make you mine. Hello, hello. Welcome back once again to Hokkaido. And today, we are going to get somebody else to do our dirty work for us. We're going to do the not malpractice challenge, which basically entails setting everything up to get the chief surgeon or the head surgeon, whoever it is, to kill Eric Soder's for us. So for this we are going to need a weapon and a disguise. So as you can see, we've come all the way down to the cable car area. There are two guards over here. And what we're going to do, I've picked up the scissors from my suite and the lead pipe, which is right where I am standing. I'm going to throw the lead pipe. That'll distract one of the security guys over here. One of the bodyguardy types, the crazy eight, and we're gonna launch the scissors at the back of his head. So that's him out of the way. Right, we're gonna grab the scissors, his gun, and his outfit, and the lead pipe while we're here. So what we need to do now is go to Yuki's room and retrieve a kill list. Basically, very easily to done with this disguise. You can just walk in and walk out, unless Yuki's already in the room, in which case her bodyguard is right there and he's an enforcer. So we're going to have to wait them out. So I've come into the bathroom and I'm just going to wait them out. So basically, the gist of this is that on the kill list is the chief surgeon's father's name, saying that basically the ICA eliminated his father on Eric Soder's orders. We then give him a load of drugs and send him back into the operating theatre and see what happens. So Yuki's now leaving, a bodyguard will go with her, leaving this room, although it's full of guards, not a single enforcer, so you can just walk right over to the computer over in the corner here, grab the kill list, and we're good to go. So what we need to do now is plant the kill list in the operating theatre, in a computer there. Now to do this, we are going to need a surgeon's outfit. Now I was going to go a different way, but when I was watching a video, someone was doing this particular part of the challenge, and I realised I can go this way. They went on to kill Yuki in the sauna, I believe. But what we're going to do, we're going to come down this corridor here, We're going to take these stairs on our right. I am considering just going round, because that's where we need to be, is just over there, basically. But I figure this way would be easier. If you want, you can take out the security cameras while you're down here. So we're just going to walk round through this section here. Not alerting anyone. Just patrolling. Everything's fine. So in here, there's the two morgue technicians. They are both enforcers. But essentially, we want to get to the door opposite where we are. So waiting for the surgeon to turn around there. Not the surgeon, the morgue technician. We're going to creep walk our way through this room and then up the stairs. And up here, as in my previous video, there will be a female doctor or surgeon, I think she may even be, just in the room with Sodas, basically, and we need to take her out. And she will come in the room, we'll knock her out, and then we need to do this god-awful peekaboo technique, which I'm really not great at. But the glass is bulletproof, so I can't just shoot the guy through the window. I need to get him to come out of that room, basically. So we've knocked out the female surgeon. We're going to pull her body out over here. That's her out of the way. She will be found shortly. See, what I would love to do at this point is just pull out my gun, aim through that window and through the next window, shoot the guy, run in there, grab his outfit, run away. That's not possible. But luckily, I have managed to get his attention without it going completely wrong, and standing there as well has drawn him right into the room, because usually when I try this, he doesn't actually come into that room at all, and I end up getting spotted and all the guards come running in and I get killed before anything else can happen. Now unfortunately he didn't come far into that room, and I've been either spotted or he got seen being knocked out. So I'm going to run down the stairs. I'm looking for somewhere to hide. And the only place I can think of off the top of my head really is further down the stairs by the, I don't know what you call it, the staff quarters, basically. So I'm going to wait here until it all blows over. I've got the outfit I need. I've got the information I need. All I need to do now is plant the information in the computer upstairs. So it looks like everyone might be going back to their routines. Luckily I didn't actually kill anyone, so there won't be people dragging bodies or running around with guns anywhere. So we need to make our way back upstairs now. Although there is a surgeon down here and I don't know why. So back the way we came, back up the stairs, back into this little room here. Now there are no enforcers now, and because I wasn't spotted, no one's looking for me, I'm not compromised in any way, I can just walk straight in here and straight up to the computer. And as usual, my terrible timing, the chief surgeon is actually stood at the computer I need to be at. So we're gonna once again have to wait somebody out, but luckily he doesn't take long and he moves away. I said luckily he doesn't take long and he moves away. Thank you. So once everyone's got their backs to you like that, you just implant the kill list and we're good to go. Now the chief surgeon will see that and start getting worked up and angry, and he's going to come and see the helicopter pilot for some drugs. There's the pilot there on the left in the red. So what we're going to do is we're going to come down here. There's a little security room down here, or a storage room or some sort. There's a security guard asleep in here. We're going to make sure he stays asleep. Pick up this crowbar, I believe it is, yes. Alright, you out of the way. We're going to hide his body. basically the pilot will make his way down here. So we're just picking up all the evidence. So all we've got to do now basically is wait for the pilot to make his way down here. Unfortunately, the chief surgeon has gone to see him first. So we've got to wait for them to finish their little conversation. And once that's finished, the pilot will make his way down the stairs towards that little security room, which is where he keeps his drug stash. Here he comes now. So all we've got to do is knock him out, take his outfit, and meet back up with the surgeon. This takes a little while. The surgeon, sometimes he'll come back straight away, sometimes he's a long time waiting. You'll see in this one it is quite a long wait. So that's the pilot down the stairs and unconscious. We're going to drag him into this room, put him in the crate with the security guard, and then we're going to take his outfit. Why is no one listening to my directions? I said take his outfit. There we go. Alright, so go outside. We want to pick up the crowbar. And I see a pair of feet. I look up. It's the gardener. But luckily, not an enforcer or anything like that. Just looking suspicious. He must have heard something. So we make our way back up to the helicopter area. You can't go past these guards without being frisked. Even as a surgeon, as you'll find out. And we're going to wait now for the chief surgeon to come back. And as you can see, we are running at ludicrous speed. And we are running at ludicrous speed for quite some time. You know, I think in real time, this is a good 2 minute wait, something like that. You know, I was able to get up and go away and make coffee. So I'm not complaining. But the surgeon should be making his way over towards the helicopter any second now. He should be coming into view. He'll come through those doors over there. Action! So there he goes. He's going to come over and ask for some more pills from the pilot.
Show you where my stash is.
Hey, I get it. Not errand boy. Lead the way.
Right, so we're gonna lead the chief surgeon down to the little storage slash security room, and we're gonna give him a nice hefty dose. I'm assuming it's some sort of mind-altering drug, but it's never specified what it is. And the effects of this is, basically, the chief surgeon is stewing about the death of his father, and he blames Eric Soders, rightfully so, I believe. And instead of going back upstairs and operating on him, he goes back upstairs and kills him, doing your work for you. So here he goes, the effects are kicking in. He's losing his temper, and he's off to kill Eric Soders. Now I'm gonna follow him if I can get into the right outfit. I need to get back into the surgeon's outfit. No, pilot. So there we go, surgeon's outfit. It's at this point I realize you can't get past them guards even as a surgeon without being frisked, and I am bristling with weaponry. So we're going to circumnavigate the guards because I do happen to know another way in. And we'll come up through this ramp onto the mountain path, into the door here, out that door, down the stairs, along here, and here we are. And I made it just in time to watch Soders die. And there you go, that will get you the not malpractice challenge. quite a lot to do in that one, fair bit of waiting around, but satisfying overall. I've been Anubis, and I will see you all in the next video.